Hey, Eran Stern here, and in this tutorial, I'll show you how to work with variable fonts inside After Effects. So at the time of this recording, After Effects doesn't support variable fonts natively. To work around this limitation, you have a couple of third-party tools. One of them is the Variety script, and another one is the VariFont plugin. I'll put a link for both of them in the description below. However, in this video, I will only demonstrate the VariFont plugin, which is more flexible and offers almost all the text animator options that you come to love and cherish inside After Effects. But first, let's take a moment to explain why you should care about these variable fonts. So first, what is a variable font? Well, this is a font that is able to store continuous range of design variants. An entire typeface can be stored in such a file with an infinite number of fonts available to be sampled. And by the way, there are some fonts that ships with Creative Cloud and can be used inside Illustrator, Photoshop, and InDesign. But the rest of the applications doesn't support them yet. So let me show you how this works inside Illustrator. So I already typed in this line that you may know. I'm going to return to it towards the end of this tutorial, so make sure to stick around to see an animated version of this line. But now I'm just going to select the text and then triple click on the first line to select it. Now in this case, I'm using the Acumen variable concept, which is shipping with Illustrator, Photoshop, and InDesign. Of course, you can use a regular version inside After Effects and other applications, but over here, we also have these options, which if I'll click on them, will reveal three things that we can change. So the first slider is going to help us to change the weight. The second one is the width, and the last one is the slant. So this is how it works over here. And I've used different weight, width, and slant versions of this font to modify different words, as you can see, for this paragraph below. So this is very cool, but what I would really like to do is animate or morph between those different width, heights, and other options. And to do this, I'll switch to After Effects, and I'm going to show you how to use the VariFont, which is a third-party solution from AE Scripts. And this is something that you can try and buy. Now there is a link in the description below, and I must tell you that I'm not affiliated by them. I just think this is a great tool and I want to show you how it works. So I already started with this composition, it's blank, and I'm going to press Command or Control Y if you're working on the PC to create a new solid. I'll name this one Relax because this is what we are going to animate. You will see it in a moment and I'll click OK. Then I'll go to the Effect menu, and under Brain.Design, I'll choose the VariFont effect. Over here, I'll click on Set, and this is going to open up its dedicated window where I can type whatever I like. Now, this plugin will allow you to enjoy all the font's qualities of your variable fonts, and you can tick this option to see all the fonts that you have in your system. I've put few links below to free fonts that you can install, but there are plenty on the internet floor. This can dynamically animate the properties that we saw a moment ago, and you can also use text animators with range selections, shape controls, and randomness, very similar to the built-in tools that you can find in the After Effects timeline. However, we need to start using it through this plugin interface. So for this instance, I'm going to choose the Roboto Flex. Again, there's a link in the description below. And I'm going to select what it says over here, and I will change it to Frankie Say, and then I'm going to click OK. Over here, in the VariFont options, I'll start by changing the font size. I'll set it to 200. And I'm also going to change the alignment to center. You can see that it also opens up in the timeline. I don't need to see it right now, so I will collapse it over here. And I'll return to all the things that I can do using this Roboto Flex variable font. Anyhow, I'm just going to play with a few of those values to show you what we have here, that you will get a sense of everything that you can do. All right, I'll start from the bottom axis, which is the extra. I'll set it to 50, and then I will shift tab, so I'll tab up to the axis 7, which is this YOPQ. Those things controls the way the stroke is actually drawing. I'm going to change them to 50. Let's also go to axis number 5, which is the slant or oblique, depending on how you want to name it, and I will set it to 50. And then for axis number 4, I'll start with a value of 20. I leave axis 3 on its default settings, 100, but I will change the weight to 4 and then the optical size to 50. I'm going to also open up the global transform and show you that you can change the position, the offset, the rotation, scale, and other properties. But for now, I just want to change the Y position and place this text a bit higher. So let's go with 220. I'll close now the global transform and let's animate the weight. So I'll create a keyframe at the beginning with a value of 4. And then I'll move 3 seconds forward and change this one to, let's go with a value of 50. Go to the beginning, press spacebar, and show you how this works. If you want, you can of course add some easing to the animation to make it more smooth, which is what I'll do in this case. I'll select the layer, and then I'll go to the animation menu and select reveal properties with keyframes, or you can press the letter U, and I'm going to select just the last keyframe over here. Press F9 to apply an easy ease, and again, preview the result. Wonderful. Now, the reason that I love this vary font is because it is still a live type, meaning that if I want to add something to what Frankie is saying, I can go back to the effect controls and I can duplicate another instance. So I'll press Command or Control D, and this one, I'm just going to immediately name it Relax, because this is what Frankie is saying. I'm also going to copy the word, click on the word set here, and just paste the word Relax. I'll work with the same font, but of course you can change it to any font you like. I'll click OK. I'll raise the font size to something bigger. So let's go with 480 in this case. I'll twirl down the global transform and I'll lower it. And then I'll collapse the global transformation. I'll go to 3 seconds where I already have this keyframe in place. And this one maybe wants to be a bit more bold. So I'll change it to 66. And then let's go to the beginning and maybe also modify it to start with a value of 20. So this is how it looks. Really cool. And of course, you can animate other options if you like. So let's do it for the third instance, which is going to be another duplicate of this guy. So I'll select the vary font relax and press Command or Control D to duplicate it again and modify the name. So over here, I'm going to type don't do it, exclamation point. Select the name, copy it to memory, just so it will be easier for me to paste it over here. I'll stick with the same font again, and now I'll reduce the font size of this version to 350. And then I'll open up the global transform and lower it so it will be under the word relax. And then let's just close the ones that we already finished working with, as well as the global transform, and modify the appearance here at the beginning of the timeline. I'll start by changing the optical size to 100. I'll leave the weight at 20. I think it looks good. I'll change the width to 100. So it will be outside the boundaries of the composition. And then the slant, I'm also going to change it to 100. And then I'll enable keyframes for other properties such as axis 4 and play with the animation. Now, I also want to mention that you can also add animators, which works very similar to what you have inside the After Effects timeline, meaning when you are applying animators to text. I will not cover this in this tutorial, but wait until the end because I will show you a few examples of how you can take advantage of them. But for now, I think this looks quite interesting, so let's preview it and see what we've managed to create. It would look even cooler if I'll show you the shy layer that I have here, which is the Frankie Goes to Hollywood logo. So let me just show it with the animation. I think it makes more sense. But those of you who are familiar with this poster knows that this should be a white background and a black text. So to achieve the original appearance, I'll create an adjustment layer, which is Command Option Y here on the Mac, Control Option Y on the Windows side. And then I'll go to Effect, Channel, add the invert effect, return back to the same category, and also add a solid composite underneath, so it will add a white background. And then again, I'll go to the beginning, maximize the composition panel, and preview the result. And I think it really looks amazing. And it was very easy to pull off. So as I promised, I want to show you a few more examples. The first one is also from Frankie Goes to Hollywood. This time it's the second album. I'll maximize the composition panel and press spacebar to preview it. And you can see how much better the animation looks. I think this adds some emotional atmosphere to the characters themselves and make them breathe on the screen. I'll pause this and then I'll open up the last one. And this is of course something that I wish I could play you, but I don't want to jeopardize with some copyright issues. So instead I will hum the tune at the same time that I'm playing you this animation. So if you need this functionality, give this plugin a try. I think it's a great typography tool, and I really hope that in the future, Adobe will add this functionality to the native text tool of After Effects. As always, I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you again in the next one.